VoxEdit. Hello and welcome to VoxElize. In this video, we're going to learn all of the tools in VoxEdit's rigging mode and assemble the character we've built in the last video. If you haven't watched that yet, you can check out the video link in the top corner. This tutorial ended up being a lot longer than I expected, so I'm actually splitting it in half from my original plan of rigging and animating in a single lesson. This video is sponsored by the Sandbox Creator Fund. The Sandbox is an upcoming game featuring assets created with VoxEdit. To learn more about the Sandbox and the Creator Fund, visit sandbox.game or see the links in the video description. In the last video, we left off with our objects in the rigger library. Let's take a quick spin around the program to get ourselves oriented. I'm working in pre-release version alpha 0.12.0, so you'll notice some of these things are missing if you still use alpha 0.3.15. We have a menu bar up top that lets us control objects in our view. Then we have the skeleton panel, our work area, library panel, timeline panel, and the brand new transform panel. Multiple screens are helpful to have a full screen work area with all the panels to the side. If you're not already familiar with 3D animation, let's get some terms down. A rig is the skeleton that we build to control 3D models. The rig or the skeleton is built up with a collection of nodes. Nodes are the point that the objects connect to. When we animate, nodes and the bones connecting them are invisible. But what we do see are the objects attached. Each node can only have one object attached, but they can have multiple children nodes. Generally, children nodes are moved when their parent node is moved, so rotating a hip bone moves the knee bone and the ankle and the toes all together. Moving a child node does not affect the parent, so it's easier for us to start with the biggest motion first and make our way down through the children nodes till we reach the last one. The root node is like the great-grandfather of all the children nodes. It's more like a folder than a node, just keeping everything together. It can't be moved, have objects attached, or deleted. The children nodes of the root node do not show bones attaching to the root because the root isn't anywhere in particular. This way you can animate separate structures under the same root without confusing bones attached to them. I know that was a lot to absorb, but I promise it'll make sense as we use it in practice. For now, we're going to show a rig that I've already built so I can show the menu bar buttons more easily. Then we're going to build a rig from the start. In the first section, we have our home button to go back to the welcome screen, our save button, and our rigging mode indicator, which becomes a button to return to rig mode if we're adding an object from our library. Next, we have the transformation buttons, move node, rotate node, and scale node. These are how we pose and animate our rigs. The next two buttons are called global and local. Remember how I said that moving a node moves its children? Well, that's only when global is left on. Switching to local lets us move nodes without affecting their children. This button will show the skeleton so we can see how nodes are connected. Show bounding boxes will make all of the object volumes visible. Remembering to trim your volumes will help keep the bounding boxes tidy. These four buttons are the same outline options we see in the modeler mode: voxel, quad, nice, and hidden. The magic wand can turn off the glow materials, which might be distracting while working on an animation. Reset view moves the camera back to the default position. Finally, there's a new edit model button, which opens the object that you have selected in the modeler without having to scroll through all the library pieces you may have in a complex rig. Now that we know the menu bar tools, I'll delete this rig and start from the beginning by right-clicking on the node and selecting delete. On alpha 0.3.15, there are buttons in the corner for these commands, except the new rename option, which can change the name of the selected node. I imagine these buttons will be coming back and are just missing from my current build. To create a new child node, I right-click on the root, select new child, and type the name, which I'll simply call Eggsby. This will be the parent node for the rest of the body parts and won't have an object attached to it. This is sometimes called an empty node, and by leaving this one empty, I'm able to control the rig more easily when animating. I can then create children nodes for the body. Every node must have a unique name, or the new node will not be created. First, I'll create a node for the bottom half. Looking over to the library panel, we can see the objects I created for the last video. I can switch between a list view and the thumbnail view. The menu at the top corner gives me the option to create a new empty VXM file, import a VXM from another folder, or import a Magic of Voxel format Vox file. When a VXM is imported, a new copy of that file is created in the same folder as your rig. Similarly, importing a Vox file will create a new VXM in the rig folder, and any changes to the VXM won't affect the original Vox file. Currently, only single object Vox files are supported. The upgrade and voxelize buttons do not appear to work at this moment. If you delete a VXM from your library using the trash can icon, it will be changed into a VXM.VXB file, which stands for voxel backup. These files remain in the rig folder, but do not appear in the library, Using the Restore Assets button will let you recover this file, which basically just removes the .vxb extension so the file is a .vxm again. All transformation and animation data is tied to the rig, not to the model. So if you accidentally delete or move an object out of the rig folder, you can simply put the object back and reattach it to the node if needed. Anything related to the position of the node will still be there. However, if you delete the node, that position data can only be brought back with an undo if you don't make more than 10 changes. Back to building our rig, I'll select the bottom object and drag it over to the bottom node. Now the object appears in our work area. Next, I'll create a child node of the bottom node and call it leg-l for the left side and attach the leg object to it. With move node selected, I slide leg L to the left side of the character. Not to my view, because I can turn any which way, and my left or right will be different from the character's. This naming convention helps keep things consistent. If we turn on the skeleton, we can see the bone connecting the leg to the bottom. I position the leg L node so it's inside the shell, where the hip bone would be on a body. Then I line up the leg so it comes out of the hole. In this particular case, that's position x 2.5, y -2.5, and z 0.5. You can see each of these numbers when hovering over the arrow handles, as well as in the transform panel, measured in units of voxels. If we want to slide an object along a plane instead of in just one direction, we can grab the outer square to move it along the XY, YZ, or ZX planes. Holding the shift key will snap an object to a whole voxel increment. This is the same control scheme used for the pivot control in the modeler mode, except holding shift snaps the pivot to half voxel increments. Once the left leg is in place, I can type 90 into the scale percentage of the transform panel to shrink the leg a little. I want there to be a slight gap between the leg and the shell so it doesn't look like it's attached to the shell, but actually going inside of the shell. Right now, all three axi are locked into being the same scale, so voxels will always be a perfect cube. Because the X, Y, and Z are listed separately, it's safe to guess that disproportionate scaling may become a future feature. I prefer typing in the scale because using the manual scale control can be a little tricky. Zooming in lets you get smaller sizes, and zooming out can give you bigger sizes, but it's simple to just type in any number and forget fussing with the zoom. Now I can select the duplicate skeleton command with the leg L node selected, and name the new node leg R for the right side. This new node is in the exact same position with the same object attached. I just want to move it to the right 5 voxel spaces from x 2.5 to x -2.5. Positioning all nodes on one side of the body, then duplicating them and moving them to the opposite side is a way to save a lot of time on complicated models and ensure that the sides are aligned correctly. The final piece to Eggsby is his top shell, so I select New Child, name it Top, and attach the top object. I want the top to slope upward from the back, so I make sure it's aligned on the Z-axis correctly, then rotate the X-axis 15 degrees, and slide the shell along the Y-X plane until it lines up nicely with the back edge. And now our rig is finally complete and ready to be animated. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring the bell to be notified when the next part of the VoxEdit tutorial is ready.